Hey guys, so today I'm going to do a haul video. I haven't done a haul in a while, but I have a few new things, so I figured I would make a video and show you them. Some of them were sent to me, so effectively they're not purchased by me. If you want to know which I bought, which I didn't, I'll put it in the down bar so that you kind of know what's what. But I just have some things that I've been sent, and then I went shopping in Boots and Superdrug, and I just kind of put it all together in one little bag and figured I would show you it all. So yeah, I hope you enjoy. So first up, I have some Lizelle products, and Lizelle are really well known for their skincare, as you probably know, and they've recently come out with like a makeup colour collection. They already have the Lizelle sheer skin tint, which I really really love, and now they've come out with like more of a range of makeup. I have two products from the range, and one is a concealer and the other is an eye pencil, and I've had these a while, been trying them out for about a week maybe. The packaging for the concealer is lovely, it's all kind of metallic silver. It's a light reflecting concealer, your typical kind of twist up concealer brush, really nice for under the eyes, I like it a lot. And then there's just a black eyeliner, which is just your typical black pencil. It's fairly soft, it's good for the waterline. At first I thought it was quite hard, but once it kind of warmed up, it was good on the waterline and it was good on the like upper lash line and stuff, so I'm pretty happy with both of those. And they have some like cream blushes and stuff that I'd really like to try out. So yeah, they're nice. And I just like the packaging, like the simple kind of classic navy packaging is really nice. Okay, next up are some nail varnishes. I got Barry M Silvery Lilac, and hopefully you can appreciate the beauty of that. Yes, I think that you can. So it's just a gorgeous duochrome one. I actually put it, I have mint green from Barry M on my nails, but I have two fingers here which I just went over. This one has silvery lilac over the mint green, not very effective. The other polish that I got was Fantasy Fire from Max Factor. And again, it's one of these gorgeous kind of just duochromes, and that is over the top of mint green on that finger. But to be honest, I think both of these would look better over darker polishes, so I'm looking forward to trying that out. Okay, next up I bought a lip liner. This is the Barry M, this is actually their Kohl pencil in number 23, and I haven't opened it yet, but it's just the colour of the pencil is pink. So this is actually a Kohl pencil from Barry M, and they do have lip liners in the same colour, and I just figured a Kohl pencil was a little bit cheaper, and I just thought, well, I can use it on my eyes, I can use it on my lips, you know, who cares? And it just looks like that. But I bought it to use as a lip liner because I don't really have a very nice pink lip liner, so that's cool. I got the new Sleek Ultra Mattes palette, and I got the dark. If you know me, you know I love Sleek, so I had to pick this up. I really want the bright one as well, but I couldn't get both. Well, I could have, but I wanted other things. So I got the darks, which I thought about it today. It kind of surprises me because I always loved bright eyeshadows, and I still love bright eyeshadows, but I don't know. I don't know if it's just maturity. Anyway, this is what it looks like. So they're all matte. And they're really great. I really like them. I used them today for my makeup. So I used like the navy, the dark purple, some black and a bit of brown in my crease. So yeah, it's really cool. And it was £6.99. They've gone up. They were like, I think when they first came out, Sleek palettes were like £4.99 or something. Now they're like £7, but whatever. I really like them, and for 12, you know, decent eyeshadows, it's a good deal. Then I picked up something that I have been wanting for so long, and they've been out a while, been out in America for ages, and they are Revlon lip butters. I got two. I would pretty much like, maybe not all of them, there are a couple of colours that I'm not keen on, but I'd like quite a few of them. It was really hard to decide which two to pick. They have a lot of pink shades, and I wanted a pink, but I didn't want like a nudie colour. It'll surprise some people, because I used to get a lot of comments telling me, like, stop wearing nude lips, you know, wear bright lipstick, move away from nude lips, blah blah blah. And I really do like bright lipsticks now, hence the bright pink lip liner. So anyway, it was a struggle to pick these two, but I managed to pick two colours that I wanted, and I got Cotton Candy and Candy Apple. Yeah, 35 and 45. So Cotton Candy just looks like this, just a really nice pink colour. It's kind of a muted pink, but it's not like a nude pink, you know, you can still tell it's on your lips. Candy Apple is like kind of an orangey red, and it's just not a colour I have anything like, and I like reds, so I got that one as well. And these are weird, like, when I was in Superdrug and I was swatching them on my hands, I was quite surprised by how pigmented they seem, but when you put them on your lips, it's completely different. I just jabbed it. And they're kind of a lot sheerer than you would expect. Very balmy, they feel really, really moisturising, and I love them. So yeah. In Boots, I can't remember what I got where, but anyway, irrelevant. I got a highlighter. This was actually in their kind of reduced to clear section, and they gave me like a £5 off number 7 voucher, and I didn't really know what to get. I wanted to try their new cleansing water because I'd read about it, but it was sold out. So I saw these, and they had loads of testers, and they had some taped up. This is the Vital Enlightening Highlighting Powder. Can't speak. And I do have up my cheekbones, although I don't know if that's going to pick up. So the packaging's really, really pretty, kind of summery. And the highlighter, I think Guerlain released something that has a similar design on the top. And it just looks like this. It's beautiful. Let me just... There you go. It's just a gorgeous, shimmery, kind of pretty, pretty colour. And there you go, you can see it shimmering there. I have it on my cheeks today. I just like highlighters, it's really, really pretty, the packaging was cute, and I only had to pay like £1.50 towards the voucher that I had, so I just figured that I would get that. I'm sorry for fiddling with my hair, it's doing my head in because I've got a necklace on and my hair's just hiding it. It's like annoying. Anyway, I got a bronzer. Now, I'm totally not a bronzer kind of girl, but I've just seen this one so many times in so many videos on so many blogs. I was just like, I'm gonna get this because it's a matte bronzer. I thought it would be good for contouring. I did use it today, but I have the hugest spot right there. Let's hide that with the hair. And it's right along my contour line, so it's not great. Anyway, get on with it. It's the Bourjois Poudre Bronzante. I'm not going to attempt to say the rest of it because I am rubbish. Bronzing powder filled with glints of sunshine. And it's their chocolate bronzer, so it looks like kind of chocolate. It's supposed to smell like chocolate. It smells sweet, doesn't smell like chocolate, but I don't know. It smells a little bit kind of cocoa sweet. But it's really, really nice actually, and it is completely matte. I got the lightest one, and there it is. And it looks really orange for some reason, but it's not. And it's very kind of faint, like very blendable. So because it's quite light, it's perfect to use as a contour when you're really pale skinned like I am. So I just got it for that, and I used it today for the first time. I like it, it's nice. I'll know more as I use it more. Then I got these two lip products from Collection 2000, and these are another thing that I've read a lot about and I've seen on blogs and stuff, and I just knew that I wanted to try them. And they're called the Cream Puffs. I got two. They have some nice nude shaded ones, but I am really trying to steer away from the nudes as much as they try to lure me in. So I got the pink and the kind of peachy coral one. These, do they have names? I don't know what they're called, you know. Oh, okay, so this one is called Fairy Cake, and this is like the peachy coral one. I'll show you the wand, just like a standard lip gloss wand. Not my usual kind of colour, but I really like it. This one is called Cotton Candy, which, funnily enough, has the exact same name as that lip butter that I got. Weird. And this is my, I don't know, I think it's my favourite of the two. I'm actually wearing it right now. And it just looks like that. Now, I love lipsticks. I used to be a lip gloss addict. Now I'm more of a lipstick addict. I really love a matte lip like this. I'm not kind of a fan of topping a matte lipstick off with a gloss. I just like matte, and these are described as velvety soft matte finish lip creams. I don't know how to explain it. You put it on and it feels really velvety and really smooth, and you rub your lips together, and I was surprised at how smooth they felt, but as you wear it, like now, it's completely dried. It feels maybe a smidgen drying, but I keep my lips kind of exfoliated and moisturised, so it's not like hideously bad. But I love that they dry to kind of like a stain, and then, you know, they just won't budge for hours. So I really love these, and I really think that Collection 2000, if you're watching, you need to bring out more colours of these, because they are awesome. Yeah. Okay, and L'Oreal have a new collection out, which is called the L'Orelectric Collection. And there's a sticker for it there, hold on. L'Orelectric, and I have the whole collection. This whole collection was sent to me, I can tell you that right now. Actually, the two Lazelle products and this collection were sent to me, so now you know. So it consists of three nail polishes, two eyeshadows and three lipsticks, and I've had this a while. I've been playing with it for a while, and I think I'm gonna do like a separate video, but I just thought I'd kind of show you. So there's three nail polishes, which I'm just trying to grab together. Look like this. These two look very similar, but they're not really. So that's those. Three lipsticks, as I said. Now, they are called Prismatic Pink, Metallic Coral and Electric Fuchsia. So this is Metallic Coral. I'm not sure it's me. It's quite an orangey shimmery colour. Like I just went on and said, I really like matte lips. However, I like the other two of these. This is Electric Fuchsia. And it's a very sheer colour. So it's good to top off another lipstick, or just for a sheer wash on the lips. Whereas Metallic Coral is very, very pigmented, like surprisingly pigmented compared to the other two. And then there's Prismatic Pink. This is really unusual. It's a very pale pink, and it just looks stunning. And it has a lot of blue shimmer in it. Once again, it's extremely sheer, but perfect to top off another lipstick. Might be really good over this actually. You can just see the blue hue, and it makes your teeth look really white, because blue shimmers in a lip product just make your teeth look whiter, so that's a bonus. I really like that. And then there's two eyeshadows, and these are the Infallible La Couleur eyeshadows, and there's two in this collection. This is Metallic Lilac, this one is Magnetic Coral, and I really like these eyeshadows. These are like almost like a pressed pigment. You get like a little thing in there and then it presses the eyeshadow down. And then there's the coral one too. Just looks like that. And I will show those in more detail in another video. I just wanted to kind of include them. And that is my haul. That's everything that I got or that I've received. I really, really love everything. If you want to know any more about anything or a review or a look or whatever, then just let me know in the comments. And thank you for watching. This is quite a long video. I apologise for that. And I'm going to go record another one now. So I will see you all later.